Hi friends, so in this session we will be discussing about the second technique or tool of financial statement analysis, that is common size financial statement analysis. So in the comparative statement, basically we considered the 2 years data and we compared with the absolute change in terms of figures as well as in terms of percentages. But the drawback of comparative statement is the evaluation or analysis of the 1 year data. How there will be relationship between the items in the balance sheet or maybe in the income statement, that is not explained in the comparative statement. That's why in the common size financial statement or common size statement, here the analysis will be focused on only one particular year. So the concept of common size financial statement we will discuss. Then the two categories will come here by considering balance sheet and income statement with some examples and as well as with some guidelines for their interpretation. So by these opening remarks, so we will go to the session, we will start the session. So the concept of common size analysis is analysis of the financial statement items through comparisons among the financial statement. And really, same year information will be considered. So, it compares the each item in the financial statement with a benchmark item. So, here one item will be considered as the benchmark or is like a standard figure, and all items will be compared with that particular benchmark. Usually in the class or maybe in the college or maybe the company, they will identify some outstanding students. And usually the performance of the other students will be compared with that outstanding student. So here, one outstanding item will be considered as or will be treated as benchmark item on all the items in the financial statement compared with that particular benchmark, and they are finding the percentages. So it is very useful in analyzing trends in profitability as well as trends in investment and financing activity. So when we will go through that particular technique of common size analysis, so we will come to know that how it will work and how it will be very useful in analyzing and interpreting the financial data in the financial statement. Fine. So the common size statement, usually we are having balance sheet and income statement. So are shown in the analytical percentages. So here I told one benchmark is considered, correct? So benchmark is nothing but in the case of actually balance sheet, the total asset or total liabilities will be the benchmark. And in the case of income statement, the benchmark is the sales. So the total sales considered as 100%, and all the items are expressed in terms of percentage of sales. And in the case of balance sheet, the total asset will be considered as 100, and different asset are expressed as a percentage of the total. So this statement are also known as component percentage or 100% statement, because every individual item is stated as a percentage of the total. And the analyst is able to assess the figures in relation to the total values. For example, if your monthly expenditure is, assume that 10,000, in the 10,000, the expenses are categorized, correct? So total expenses 10,000 will come, like for example, for rent, you will pay 2,000. With respect to the food or mess, if you are staying in PG, for example, you will pay nearly 3,000 for food monthly. Next, your education related expenses will come around 3,000. And another 1,000 expenses for your other things. Like that, if you consider. So out of that 10,000 total, so these are the heads: 2,000 for rent, 2,000, 3,000 for food, 5,000, and nearly you can take 2,000 for your education, and remaining 3,000 for others expenses. Now, in terms of percentages, how it is treated? Rent is 2,000, correct? In terms of percentage, if you take total 10,000 as 100, so proportionate percentage you need to calculate. So 2000 divided by the benchmark 10,000. So that will give you 20%. Andre, nimma idi 100% expenses alli 20% expenses nimma rent kodthiri. Next 3000 means 30,000. So 30% expenses for food. Next remaining 20% for your education, and last remaining 30% for your miscellaneous. Correct. So in preparing the budget also, the government, they are preparing one pie chart. They are identifying what is the source of money for the government, revenue for the government for rupee 1. They identify that. And what is the sources of expenditure for rupee 1. They identify that. So difference they will give, like for example, 60%. And for infrastructure, they will give 30%. So like that, the common size statement will give you component percentages. And here you are focusing on only 1 year. That's what is called as a vertical analysis. Also, it is called as a strategic or static analysis, where you are not comparing with another year. Here we are having common size balance sheet. So as I told, the statement where all the items are expressed as the ratio of each asset to the total asset. So all the items are expressed in terms of percentage of the total asset. Liabilities also with respect to the ratio of the total liabilities. That is called as common size balance sheet. So for example, if you take total asset is 5 lakh. An example they called it. In that, the closing stock or inventory we are using, correct? Inventory value is 50,000. So what is the percentage of inventory? What is the percentage of stock in that? So we will come to know that 50,000 divided by 5 lakh multiplied by 100. So that will give you 10%. It means 10 shekara asset alli stock in a value 10 shekara undu. So stock is representing 10% of the total asset. So the steps here, it will be like this. Usually you need to specify the amount of assets and liabilities in column number 1 and 2. Third column, here usually I think directly you can go for calculation. Second step, what you will do? The total asset or total liability are considered as 100. And third step, all the individual assets are expressed as a percentage of total asset. That is, in terms of percentages with respect to the total asset, you will explain. So this is the format of the income statement. Common size balance sheet. So two companies information they given here. So assets, liabilities you mentioned. Now here you can see that total asset is fixed to 100. So in this column you will write all the amounts given in the problem. So here you need to find out the percentage. So all the items percentage you are calculating against the total asset. So similar case with respect to the liabilities also. So benchmark here is total liabilities. So here common size income statement is like similar manner. So the items are represented in the income statement can be shown as percentage of sales to show the relationship of each item to the sales. So here the benchmark item is sales here. Sales are now null at the consider martheve, and remaining all the items in the income statement will compute the percentage in relation to the sales. So then we will come to know that the gross profit, operating expenses or the operating profit, and ultimately the net profit, what is the percentage in relation to the sales. So ultimately a relationship can be established between the sales and all the items in the income statement, and this relationship is helpful in evaluating the operational activities of the enterprises. So it will help for the interpretation. So the pro forma will be like this. So first draft the income statement here. Here sales, first I told should be equivalent to 100. You will first get sales and 100% the considered madbeko, and remaining all the items you need to calculate the percentage against the sales. So we'll take an example here before we'll proceed with the revision. So how common size first income statement will be done. First we'll focus on that. This is a simple problem we taken here. So sales they given with respect to the two years they given, 2018 and 19 illi. So 5 lakh and 7 lakh less cost of sales or cost of goods sold, gross profit. Now common size income statement, how we'll do? First you will fix sales is 100%. This is the first task you need to do here. Similarly here also it's already I mentioned. So for the 2 years the sales should be 100. Fine. Yeah. Now what is the percentage of cost of sales in the 100%? So how we'll calculate this? Is equal to the cost of sales divided by the benchmark item, that is sales, into 100. So that will give you the percentage of cost of sales. Andre sales ina 66% enagide cost of sales agide. Ade riti gross profit est agide, 170,000 divided by 5 lakh, that is sales, into 100. We do that, it will give you 34%. Similarly here for 2019, if you consider 5 lakh 10 divided by the sales into 100, so that will give you 72%, and same calculation if you drag here, it will give you 37%. So next we can go for comparative statement. So but this is the concept of common size. So all the items represented in relation to sales. Similarly we'll go for common size balance sheet. Now this is the liability side I considered here, capital, reserve, debentures, and current liability item you are having, and you are having total liability. So now first what you will do, that you already specified the amount here. Next task is fix 100% against the total liabilities. Then all the items you need to calculate the proportionate percentage, andre equity share capital percentage in relation to sales. How? The value of equity share capital divided by total into 100. We need to do that. So that will give 31%. Adhere the same calculation I will made. 3 lakh divided by total 13 lakh into 100. So that will give 23%. So similar calculation if you do that, so the total of these item that will give you 100%. One minute. If you drag that, I think automatically the values you will get. It's not coming. You need to calculate that. Fine. So 3 lakh divided by 13 lakh into 100. So that will give you 23%. Next, 2 lakh divided by total into 100. Fine. So like that, we need to calculate the percentage for the remaining items. Is equal to 1 lakh divided by 13 lakh, the total into 100, so that will give 8%. I think here also you can write 8%, that is same. Here it is 4, here it is nearly 1 lakh 50 divided by total 100. Yeah, so the total of these items is equivalent to 100. Later you will get that. So ultimately here we can conclude with respect to the balance sheet, the benchmark is the total asset or total liabilities, and each item in the balance sheet is restated as percentage of total assets and liabilities. In the case of income statement, the benchmark is the sales. Each item in the income statement is restated as percentage of the sales. And later you can go for the interpretation. Thank you.